This video is sponsored by Noctua. They provided the fans that I show in this video. In this video, we're gonna upgrade my 10 gigabit network cards with active cooling. This is my solar flare. I really like this card. It's a much more modern card than the Celsio, but this one really needs active server airflow in your case, otherwise it overheats, and it already overheated one time and Windows dropped it even completely out of the operating system. So we need to put a cooler on here, and also this Celsio T420 also needs to have a cooler. And I'm gonna install the correct full height bracket. The fans that I chose to upgrade the card with is the Noctua NFA4X10, and it comes in this really nice premium package with a lot of info, and also here a lot of info. I really love this kind of packaging. Here's some info about the bearings, here's some info about the fan blades. There's a lot of extra accessories included, so let's open the box. It comes with a small manual, so you can see how you can install it and some tips with the extra cables. In the box we find a lot of extra accessories. So it's not the cheapest fan, but with all the extra stuff you get, I think it's a really nice deal. So it comes with mounting screws, a fan splitter, a low noise adapter, an extension cable. Let me see how long it is. Around 30 centimeters. It comes with this extra connector. If you have a card where you replace the fan and you need to power the fan of the card, you can use this system to put this plug on the card with some joints here. Really nice to see that they included this, and this is described in the description how you can use this. It also comes with four special mounting rubber pieces. Okay, this doesn't work. The holes in the card are too small. So here we have the fan itself. It comes with a 4-pin PWM connector. The cable is around 20 centimeters. On all the corners we have small rubber pieces. A nicely designed fan. It's 40 by 40 millimeter and 10 millimeters height. What I really love about Noctua is the amount of cables and mounting hardware you get. This is what came with the four 40 millimeter fans, and this is what came with four CPU coolers and four case fans. I got this Celsio T420 and it came out of an appliance, so that is why this custom bracket is installed. So I ordered the right full height brackets on eBay. So let's install them first on the cards. So this looks much better on the cards. I already installed a fan on this solar flare card. So let's do this solar flare card, and one of the cards will be going into my server and the other one is going into my workstation. So I found these two screws. I made them a little bit shorter, but they are the perfect size to fit in between the cooling block here. So we have a nice fit of the coolers. I really love how this looks. But there's one downside on this method, and that the card doesn't fit in one slot anymore. The heatsinks on the Celsio T420 are much smaller and doesn't allow to crimp screws in it. And even the 40mm fan is bigger than the heatsink. But on this card we have two holes here. I think I'm gonna use zip ties to mount the fan on top of here. And the Celsio cards are for, like, in my backup file server and into a test server or a second workstation. So they are less important than the solar flare cards. So what you can do with the zip ties is put them through the holes. Then you put the fan over the zip ties. And then you take another set of zip ties, put them over here. So you make a stop here. And then you cut off the zip ties. And now we have mounted the fan. So let's do the last card. I really love how this turned out. The 40mm Noctua fans looks awesome on the network cards. So a really big thank you Noctua for providing the fence for in this video. I really appreciate it. And the nice thing about the fence is you get 6-year warranty on them. So they really stand behind the product. There's one thing left to do with the cards, and that is installing them in the systems. So let's put the Chelsea card back into my current file server. And here on the motherboard we have a fan header. So the card is installed and the fan is spinning. In the server we have 5 PCIe slots and 1 32-bit PCIe slot. Not sure why they put it in, but yeah, it doesn't matter that much. All the PCIe slots are the PCIe 3.0 standard. And we have a 4x slot, 16x8x16x8x. We have 40 PCI lanes per CPU, so we have 80 PCI lanes in total. So even if we fill up all the slots, they still will run at full speed. So let's put the card here in this PCI slot, because we don't need the old PCI slot and the fan can hang above it. And here on the motherboard we have 4-pin PWM connectors, normally for the rear fans, but I don't think I need to have the rear fans in if I have enough airflow over the board. So the last machine to do is my workstation, and I have 2 PCIe 16 slots and 2 PCIe 4x slots. But this is an 8x card, so I'm gonna put the card in the second 16x slot here under the video card. So I hope that works out in terms of cooling, otherwise I need to swap down the video card to this slot and the network card on top of it. The card is installed, so let's connect the fiber optic cable. I really like the Noctua NFA410. It's a really nice little fan and it only makes 19.6 decibels of noise. So that is not much. What I really like about the Noctua fans, the noise that you hear is only wind noise and no noise of bad bearings or things that are resonating in your system. They really run nice and silent. When I was mem testing the server ran for 19 hours and my father slept 1.5 meter away with only a wall in between, and he didn't complain about the noise of the server. You could hear the wind noise of the server, but not a rambling noise or like a vibrating table or... So the fans and the bearings run really smooth, and that is what I really like about Noctua. Because my i7 workstation here has another brand of fans, and that was making noise on my desk and that came through the wall. And also my Intel test server, I had to put it on a piece of foam, otherwise my table was resonating the sound. And with the Noctua fans you don't have that issue. I really like the Solarflare 10 gigabit cards. They run under Windows, Linux, FreeBSD without any issues. And if you want to pick it up, I have a link in the description to the seller, and that will be a tweakers.net link where he sells his stuff. So you can pick it up from him if you want that. And otherwise, if you want to pick up the Noctua fans, I will put Amazon affiliated links in the description. Thanks for watching, and if you like to support me, I have Patreon, I have Amazon affiliated links, I have Twitter, and you can join Retro Machines on Facebook. The mem test ran for almost 19.5 hours, one successful pass, and is now on 20% of the second pass and 0 errors, and the CPU is nice around 39 degrees, and even with the cover half on the machine.